The Astronomy Photographer of the Year has just been announced from a cast of thousands of amateur and professional entrants from 91 countries, which means we have some stunning images to show you, including this one. And with me here in the studio, the man who took this particular image, Martin Lewis, and one of the competition judges, lifelong astronomy enthusiast John Culshaw. Thank you both for coming to talk to us here on Global. Now, Martin, this image is Parade of the Planets. That's and right. It's not one single image, is it?
No, it's a composite of seven separate sessions. So each of the planets there is a night's work in grabbing the videos.
Hours and hours
of processing to bring out the details, and then seven separate occasions, and I've brought them together. And it was only towards the end of the year that I realized that I would be able to capture all the planets in one year from my back garden.
I love that. This is all done from your back garden.
Detail in every single planet. So the hard thing was the planet at the end, furthest from the sun, is Neptune. And last year there were a number of large spots visible on Neptune, which was quite unusual because it's normally quite a bland planet. And that's when the idea occurred to me, let's get a montage of all the planets with detail.
You have so much detail and so much colour emerging in this image, and yet the image from you that won its category, that pipped this image,
yes,
is very, very simple looking. Yes. Let's look at Venus.
Yes, so that is just an image where I've tried to capture the exquisite beauty of a fine crescent Venus. So, there's something very special about... Yeah, you can see it now on the screen. So I've tried to capture a very, very fine crescent, and everyone's impressed by a crescent, you know, whether it's a crescent moon or, in this case, the crescent Venus.
It kind of makes me shiver looking at it. It's just going to get that existential shiver just looking at that. And let's bring in John here, because as a judge, it's obviously about incredible photography, but is it also about when you get that shiver?
Oh, very much. The images not only have to be technically great, but also emotional. You've got to be inspired by them. And you really do have to have a feeling for them.
One particular image I want to bring in here is, I think, the overall winner. Now, this is Transport the Soul by an American photographer, Brad Goldpaint. What a great name.
Yeah, Brad Goldpaint.
Tell us a little bit about this image, John.
This was the overall winner of the competition, and all the judges loved this because it shows the Earth in rather an alien sense, almost Martian. And the technical brilliance of capturing the Milky Way over that earthly terrain. And with the observer there in the picture, it just sums up that feeling of why we enjoy astronomy so much. We feel connected to the universe. And that image just caught that feeling, and everyone was just drawn to it. All the judges, we just had that draw to that overall winner.
And Martin, you were one of the winners, but you're one out of a very large cast. A lot of people take images, are drawn to photograph the sky. Yeah. So, a cheeky question, do you have thousands of pounds worth of kit?
No, both my telescopes. So these were all taken, except for the first image, which is Mercury, with my larger telescope is home-built, my smaller telescope's home-built, and I've got a tracking platform, and that's home-built as well. So it's a cheap way of getting equipment, and you can then build the equipment to match exactly what you need out of it, and have all sorts of...
So you have to be handy, you have to be thoughtful and prepared to put a lot of time into it.
Yeah, I mean, there's no better time to get into astronomy. As far as buying telescopes, they're, you know, fantastic quality telescopes you can buy for a few hundred pounds now from China.
And John, you have your own, don't you, telescope set up in your garden or your window?
Yes, that's right. But the beauty of this competition is that anybody can try it. One of the... classic images from a couple of years ago was a shot of a total solar eclipse from an aeroplane taken on a mini tablet by a boy who was 8 years old. Just click.
Gosh.
Those can come through as well. So anybody can try it.
And in fact, we're just showing an image of the moon that I think you took. Two images
there
that you took, John, yourself. Obviously, a huge amount. I'm just going to encourage our audience. I'm going to tweet a link to the competition and some of the winners as well. And congratulations, Martin. Just in the very final seconds of the programme, I want to bring in the fact that John is a very busy man. You're also a professional satirist and what would I say, impressionist?
Impersonator,
however you like to put it.
Yes.
And I could not resist putting it to you that in these days of Donald Trump, there was a lot to work on.
You see the face happen straight away.
I love astronomy, I love astronomical objects, I love the moon is awesome. Imagine the great golf courses you could have on the moon. Imagine the gravity, you could have so much fun, it's awesome.